The Philippine Senate not keen on amending the Constitution. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri says it won't be a priority in the upper chamber since many of his colleagues find it divisive. Senator Robin Padilla earlier said he will pursue charter change with or without the backing of the president.
Gusto pong pag-usapan ni Senator Robin Padilla itong issue on charter change sa committee niya. He has the mandate to do so, he can do so, but it's not a priority of our administration particularly. We'd like to finish the 20 priority measures that are still pending with us.
For Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel, the country can generate foreign investments even without amending the Constitution. Instead, Pimentel says it's the political provisions that should be changed. But he adds discussions on this can come second to responding to more pressing issues in the country. The Commission on Higher Education says colleges and universities now have the option to choose their learning mode. According to CHED Chairman Prospero De Vera, higher education institutions can decide whether to hold fully online or fully in-person classes or blended learning. But CHED will still assess if their chosen learning system is feasible. A previous CHED order had said colleges and universities could no longer implement distance learning in the 2022 to 2023 academic year. The memorandum has since been taken down from CHED's website. Acting Health Secretary Maria Rosario Vergere has been tagged in a complaint over supposed irregularities in the agency's cancer treatment program. Adrian Ayalena joins us on the line with the details. Adrian?
Hi, Denise. Department of Health Officer in Charge Maria Rosario Vergere has been included in the complaint against officials over a cancer treatment program which supposedly deprived patients of their regular supply of medicines. DOH Medical Officer for Dr. Clarito Cairo Jr. filed his amended complaint affidavit before the Office of the Ombudsman on February 13, 2023. Last year, Cairo Jr. accused 7 former and current officials of the DOH of committing grave misconduct, malversation, and graft for allegedly depriving cancer patients of their medicines. In his amended affidavit, Cairo said Vergere allegedly failed to reply to his memorandum in 2022. He also said that Vergere had full control of funds as OIC and concurrent Undersecretary for Public Health Services team of the DOH. Vergere, meantime, said she, as well as the other officials included in the complaint, have yet to receive a copy of the document. But Vergere, like all officials mentioned in the complaint, said that all processes concerning DOH programs, specifically those involving cancer funds, were above board and were done in a transparent manner. Back to you, Denise.
Thanks, Adrian. Authorities have arrested a group of people accused of selling fake land titles. Police nabbed 7 individuals in an entrapment operation in Cavite. According to the Anti-Organized Crime Unit, the group uses land titles pawned to them. Lieutenant Colonel Jovit Kulaway says the suspects would also falsify documents and tamper with legitimate titles to defraud victims. They will face charges of estafa, falsification of documents, and the use of fictitious name under the revised penal code. Authorities are also advising the public to scrutinize documents or have them certified when purchasing land.
Ikaw na ano ka, na biktima ka, pati yung mga ano mo, yung mga, yung pangalan, kung nakuha nila, nagagawa nila ng mga fake na mga DTI na mga certificate, na mga business permit. So, it's a warning sa public na maging aware tayo sa mga, especially dito sa mga pakikipag-transact sa mga private na mga tao sa mga lending-lending. Kasi pag-uutang, akala mo, tunay na tutulong sa iyo, yung pala masalo kang mabibigatan.